So this is kind of a crazy setup we've got here. It's raining a little bit. I've set up a little table umbrella so I can work outside of the rain, or out from the rain. Time's running short. We're going to be picking these goats up pretty soon, and I need to get some work done, so I can't let the rain stop me.
Because the posts are round and the latches are flat, I will have to notch into the posts. I'll also be using a 2x2 to span the gate posts as a way of visualizing the correct angles.
Thank you.
going to try and do is match the other side of the gate. So, Brendan, do you think you could grab the 2x2 and put it right along the middle of the last post so I can see the angle and height? And I want to actually stretch it from this one to here as well, so.
What do you want to do now?
Okay, we're going to put it from the middle of that H brace there, so it's right in the middle. No, I mean, centered on the on the width. Okay, so this will tell me the height.
Remember your.
Yep. This is the height. So now let's bring the 2x2 right over here to get the right angle between these two posts. Okay, so that will be the angle. And partway in, what do you think? Is that right? No. Sorry. This is the one that goes partway in. This is the corner. This is the one I'm going to have to drill in from the other side all the way this way. So I'm going the wrong way. What we want to do is put the level on this 2x2.
Oh, it's right here.
And put it right, drill line, okay, wherever it makes level.
It was right there.
Okay. Still centered. This way. That looks like 73 exactly. All right, so. See if that's enough. Probably enough.
I think it is. Sit it right.
Yep.
You gotta put the level right there for me.
Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do an eyeball judgment based on the height of the other one. That's really close to perfect. Just down to touch, Brian. That'll be a starting spot at least.
Watch out, Dad.
You could move, Dad, just so I can see.
Oh, I moved it down.
Try coming down a little bit more. Up just a touch. That looks right to me. I trust that better than the level, just so it looks right.
You know the rule, just don't drill my hands in
your hand. Yep. Let's center it right on the pole. That's good. All right.
Good.
This next one will go partway in, and again, we're going to want to have a straight edge for the angle of the drill.
Go ahead and just measure it. Did you get far enough?
Yeah. 78 and a half.
Okay.
Good, 178 and a half earlier.
Visually, you know, it's kind of helpful sometimes just to hold them up and see what it looks like, but...
I know, but as long as we had one to do it with, you could just cut the other one down there.
Yeah. All right, so...
I guess it'll be for that, or there should be no problem. You're gonna guide it, right?
There we go.
When you stood down, okay.
Yeah. Hold on, man.
Is it a little tight, or is it gonna make it? All right.
We don't even need a pin on this side, Brian's fine.
Where's your level?
Yeah, let's try the level.
Okay. Right here.
Okay. Hold it perfect, look at that.
Right there. Brian, this doesn't need anything.
This is a little duct tape.
All right, that feels just right.
I'm actually glad I can have all the rest of my clamp.
Yeah, good.
Oh, hold on, man. Hold on. That came down when I did it. You check it again?
Okay.
Yeah, it came down when you...
Right there.
Okay, go. Okay.
Level two, Grimes has got a hold of it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. up a little bit more. Just a little bit more.
So hold on, Bry. Okay, never mind. I was making sure we weren't gonna run into the gate.
Yeah. Yep. All right. So
I think we just measure.
This will be the one that'll be partway drilled in, I believe. And I'll just use the post that you got there as my angle, if I can. Yep. You're standing on the corner. Oh. Thank you. Down a little bit, yeah. Right about there. That's a good angle.
Go. I got you.
Okay.
Sure.
I was going to check. I thought you might have gone a little bit an angle that way. But
I
See what I'm talking about? Just a hair, but the... Well, that's straight. That's,
yeah,
that's
go, going all the way in. We can. Okay, good.
Measure it?
Yep.
Yeah.
Actually, I can probably just measure straight from the pin over.
Perfect.
Okay.
Well, we like it when you cut it a little bit long.
Yeah, yeah, just that little touch.
Yeah. Difference.
So I'd say 71 and an eighth.
All that?
Just one of those little pieces.
Oh, sorry about that.
No, I would not have expected it to. Got part of it.
I got a hole right here.
That's okay. I think it's probably, isn't that funny? I mean, I'm fine. It was all moist. It was just,
Oh, like a finger. All right.
There we are.
Oh, wow.
Might as well check the level again. That's right.
Perfect.
Here.
Looking cool.
Go up a little down. Just a little bit more. Just touch. There we are.
It's like we know what we're doing.
We're using double barbed staples.
brace wires have a good deal of pressure on them. The tension helps distribute the strength in the fence corners. The folks from Northwest Landscape Care came out to stretch the fence for us once we had everything ready to go.
All right, so rookie mistake on my part. Never done a fence like this before. I didn't measure the height of the fence before I put in these supporting cross pieces. The fence itself has to staple to this cross post, but now it won't go all the way down to the ground. So to fix that, I'm just going to have to piece in more of those cross supports along the bottom, and then we'll staple to it after the fact. So not the end of the world, just a little more money and time. That seems to be the way these projects go. Just always a little more money and time than you think. So we're wrapping the fence around these end posts by the gates and other places where the fence ends. And the fence itself, of course, is on the inside of the pin. So when the goats are pushing against it, they're a little more, fence is a little more secure that way. Does it make sense to wrap it all the way around and then twist it to the fence itself, or is this pretty common with the stapling it as it wraps around?
Oh, that's good. Yeah, that's good. And then we'll just fold these backwards. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is enough support.
Okay.
Because we're putting every one.
Sure.
Yeah. And then some looks more. Yeah, and then it actually gives it a better look.
All right. Just looking on YouTube, I just had noticed how they always seem to strip back several links and then have enough wire to go all the way around and then twist it too.
Yeah, sometimes they do that, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's...
It's not going anywhere.
Yeah, especially if we do this on the top too. Mm-hmm. And then if you were going to do something on the bottom, that's more than enough.
Yeah, okay, good, yeah. Good.
Can we go on the side?
Yeah, you bet.
Okay.
You bet.
Oh, okay. Good.
In fact, I'll grab a ladder for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been hopping over the fence to work on this myself, so I know the farmer who leases the property, so yep. It's all good. Nice. Securing to a tree to pull against, so the fence will be nice and tight. Thank you. really appreciate your expertise. Is there a rule of thumb about how tight to pull it? I know you're not supposed to over-tighten these things, obviously,
yeah,
but...
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, just to the point where it's nice and straight.
Yeah. A lot of times you see people pulling these things with tractors, but I guess the manufacturer recommends against that because the fence is meant to have a little bit of play back and forth once it's taut. You know, you don't want it to be so tight that the knots are literally pulling against each other and there's no give at all.